Ships in South China Sea. Why was the U.S. Air Force's tank tracking ground surveillance plane flying circles over the western Pacific south of Taiwan on Monday? The answer might lie in what else the four-engine E-8C Joint Surveillance Target Attack Radar System can do and what else is in the area. The JSTARS not only can detect armored vehicles crawling across a desert, it also can spot ships at sea. And right now, there are a lot of ships, Chinese and American, in the waters around Taiwan. JSTARS is a Boeing 707 with an underslung and APY-7 synthetic aperture radar. The radar includes a so-called ground-moving target indicator function, meaning it can spot a vehicle in motion and, over time, show operators where the vehicle has been and where it's going. Air Force has 17 JSTARS. The Georgia-based planes famously tracked Iraqi tanks in the desert during the 1991 Gulf War, helping Allied forces to destroy hundreds of them. But GMTI doesn't just work over land. It also works over water. Scanning 200 square miles at a time, E-8 can pick out small boats against the clutter of waves. It's not for no reason the Air Force has deployed E-8s to spot drug-running boats in the Caribbean. When the U.S. Navy's new P-8 patrol plane entered service in 2013, the Air Force wasted no time working out tactics for combining the two types. The E-8 scans huge swaths of water. The P-8 descends to low level to visually inspect the most interesting targets. The U.S. used the complementary strengths of JSTARS and the P-8 to positively identify maritime vessels over a large area of responsibility and determine whether they were friendly, enemy or neutral, Victor Ellis said, an Air Force liaison officer following 2015 Naval War Game. In recent years, JSTARS have flown from the Air Force megabase at Kadena in Okinawa. Lately, there's been plenty of work for the JSTARS in the region. The Chinese Navy in late 2020 has orchestrated a series of major naval exercises involving both of its aircraft carriers. The Chinese War Games compelled the Taiwanese military to deploy Marines, fighter planes and drones to outlying islands. The U.S. fleet has met the Chinese deployments with deployments of its own. At the same time the E-8 was flying over the waters south of Taiwan on Monday, the assault ship USS America, the aircraft carrier USS Ronald Reagan, two landing ships and several escort vessels were converging in the western Pacific for an exercise. The E-8 in the air on Monday was hundreds of miles from America and Ronald Reagan, but it was just 100 miles from the Chinese coast, close enough to detect Chinese warships leaving port. For all its maritime prowess, the E-8's future is bleak. The Air Force has neglected the JSTARS, notably failing to replace its aging and inefficient TF-33 engines. Service has decided that the E-8 is too slow to survive in a major war and has asked Congress to let it retire the type. Congress denied the request, insisting that the Air Force hang on to the E-8s until the flying branch can replace their unique capabilities. The Air Force's 11 Block 40 Global Hawk drones have GMTI capability. The electronically scanned array radars on the F-22 and F-35 stealth fighters reportedly also can do what the E-8s and APY-7 does, although probably not on the same large scale. For now the E-8s remain in service, and they're still useful even in a war with China, if the type's recent sortie is any indication. Meanwhile, China's Navy hit a milestone this month, sending two aircraft carriers to sea at the same time, according to state-controlled media. The Liaoning, Beijing's first carrier, and the Shandong, commissioned at the end of last year, are both embarked on separate training missions. The Liaoning was spotted leaving its base and sailing in the Yellow Sea that weekend, according to the report. The Shandong deployed a week earlier to exercise in the Bohai Sea. China's carriers will become key forces in handling pressure from the United States in the South China Sea and Taiwan Strait, and potentially from India on China's maritime routes, Beijing-based naval expert Li Jia said. China and India have clashed in recent months along the disputed 2,175-mile border that separates the world's most populous nations. The rivals, who fought a 1962 war, have agreed not to attack each other with firearms. However, there have been occasional skirmishes along the border. A June 15th brawl involving clubs, stones, and fists killed 20 Indian troops. Beijing considers Taiwan a breakaway province that must be reunited by the mainland. The U.S.-Taiwan Relations Act of 1979, passed to coincide with recognition of Beijing's government, allows arms sales to Taiwan and calls for the U.S. to maintain the capacity to resist any force or coercion that would jeopardize Taiwan's security. Two aircraft carriers could combine with anti-ship ballistic missiles to squeeze Taiwan and prevent U.S. intervention in any conflict there. Chinese can also play a role in protecting crucial maritime transport lanes like the Strait of Malacca. However, Ian Chong, an associate professor of political science at the National University of Singapore, thinks China's carriers wouldn't be a major factor in a conflict over Taiwan. The island is well within range of China's land-based air power, evidenced by multiple sorties of Chinese military aircraft flying around Taiwan in recent years. An aircraft carrier makes marginal difference, especially if they carry less fuel and munitions than land-based aircraft, as widely reported. The vessels also wouldn't likely be very helpful in a contingency involving India. To have the carriers out in the Indian Ocean leaves them quite exposed. They are unable to put pressure on India when in the Pacific. The carriers may have some impact in the South and East China Seas, since those waters are farther from Chinese air bases. Beijing is engaged in multiple disputes with its neighbors over sea territory that encompasses vast natural resources. It has built up and militarized several small islands in the South China Sea that have become frequent targets of U.S. freedom of navigation operations. If it is the case that the Chinese wish to make some statement about power projection, this could create some pressure on other claimant states and possibly the UU. Deployment of the carriers could spur stronger responses from the US and China's neighbors. It comes down to the appetite Beijing has for escalation and what it believes the appetite for escalation of other interested actors are. Meanwhile, US warships have been engaged in larger scale and more complex training in the region. Valiant Shield, which kicked off in waters near Guam on Monday and ends September 25th, follows last month's Rim of the Pacific exercise off Hawaii, which involved navies from 10 nations with 22 surface ships and one submarine. The exercise includes the aircraft carrier USS Ronald Reagan and amphibious assault ship USS America, along with other warships and about 100 aircraft and 11,000 personnel from the Navy, Air Force, Army, and Marine Corps. Another exercise off Guam, Pacific Vanguard, began Saturday and involves 8 ships from the US, Japan, South Korea, and Australia, along with more than 1,500 sailors, one unnamed submarine, and a patrol aircraft.